Hello viewers, I welcome you all for this today's session on geometry design of railway track. In this class we will try to discuss about the speed on track, various types of the speeds on track. Myself Ashok Kumar, assistant professor, department of civil engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Learning outcome of the today's session: at the end of the session, students will be able to differentiate different types of speeds used in railway track and also calculate the speed with respect to the given cant or computed cant or super elevation. So in the previous session, we have discussed about the various types of the cants, that is equilibrium cant, cant deficiency, cant excess and negative super elevation. So in this class, we will discuss about the different types of the speeds used in the railway track. So we know that speed is the rate at which we are covering any distance. And every train is allowed to move three speeds actually. One is average speed, maximum speed. Maximum speed may be on straight track or on curves. So here we are going to see that what kind of the speed we are going to provide in the railway track and how we are going to running these speeds in different types of the tracks. So for us, the first we'll see about the average speed or equilibrium speed, then we'll come to about the maximum speed or say permissible speed. The average speeds depends on the length of the section and number of stoppages. We know that in the average speeds we are going to consider what is the length of the each section. If you are the number of stations are there and in between we have number of sections. So how many stations it is covering and how many length it is covering, so depending upon that we will decide the average speed. And we know that it is distance divided by the total time will give the average speed. So let us see how we are going to calculate the average speed. In the previous sessions also we have got to know the average speed or weighted average speed. It's calculated n1v1 plus n2v2. It is taking more or less the weighted average of all the vehicles, which are number of vehicles are traveling with different speeds. Coming to the next speed is after average speed is maximum speed. So we have to not always we have to go with the average speed. Sometime we need to go with the higher speed, maximum speed, where we considering number of stoppages are lesser. So because it's no use that if you are having more number of stations and you are saying we are going with higher speed, maximum speed here. So as the number of stoppages are lesser, then only we are going to accelerate the vehicle and get that particular maximum speed. By the time you are going to accelerate it and then you receive one more stations, that means that you are going to reduce the speed and again you are going to get a time for acceleration and deacceleration. So there we are not going to call that is maximum speed. So here wherever we have number of the stoppages are lesser, that is possible to go with the maximum speed. So again we have to reduce the travel time. For that we are going with the maximum speed. And when you are going provided the particular track with higher speed, ensure that the safety measures are taken care or not. Otherwise there might be possibility of an accident also. So some of the high speed corridors which I have taken over here is Ahmedabad-Mumbai or Pune corridor, Ahmedabad-Mumbai-Pune corridor, where we are traveling up to 350 kmph. So some of the Gatiman Express 160 kmph, then Rajdhani, Shatabdi, all these trains, they are nearly reaching up to 150 kmph. So in this case we should think about the safety, whether the proper safety measures, our track is able to take this speed or not, whether we have proper super elevation or not. All these things are taken care when we are deciding the higher speeds. After the maximum speed, we have another speed is maximum sanction speed. So we know that the maximum sanction speed is defined by the track engineer. Again, we have to take permission of the chief engineer, the person designed the track engineer. He knows what the maximum I can allow beyond this the maximum permissible speed. This is only used during the emergency condition with a prior permission of authorities. Without that, we are not supposed to go with this maximum sanction speed. Now the issue comes here. If you are going in a straight track, we are not having any issue. But when your vehicle is traveling on curves, there we have to definitely define the what is the safe speed or maximum permissible speed on the curves, because on the curves we have maybe constrained with the radius or degree of the curve, or maybe constrained with the your transition curve. So if you have any site constraint, we have to define the safe speed on curves. Otherwise, it will be ends up with the derailment of the track on that, or there is a wear and tear of the track due to the higher speed on that particular curve. So now, for any track, they should move with a speed which is lesser than the safer speed, or maximum they are attained this up to the safe speed we can attain it, but preferably to go lesser than this safe speed. So after this only we have a maximum permissible speed. As I told you, the sanctioned speed comes after this safe speed. Okay, it means we have another speed after this safe speed is maximum sanctioned speed of the track, but again that to be used only during emergency condition with prior permission from the track engineer. Otherwise you are not supposed to go reaching up to sanctioned speed. So on the straight track, in this case, it is limited by the maximum speed defined for every train. So every train is defined. So what is the speed has to travel on that particular track. Now take a pause over here and think for a moment and answer this question. Sections carrying less goods traffic, higher value of cant access should be allowed. And for sections carrying predominantly free traffic, value of cant access allowed should be kept low. What is the answer for that? I hope you are able to select the true or false. The correct answer is it true? What are the factors we are considering in the safe speed over here? We are considering what is the safe speed for the curves. Depending upon the type of the gauge, we have broad gauge, meter gauge and narrow gauge. Considering the various width, we may select what is the safe speed. And radius of the curve, we know that the radius is directly related into the safe speed. As the more the radiuses, we can negotiate that particular curve very easily. Lesser radius, we have to restrict the speed. Super elevation, again the super elevation, we know that square of the directly proportional to the square of the velocity and inversely proportional to the radius. So again, considering the speed, what kind of the radius and what kind of the speed, we have to decide what is the super elevation and safe speed. So transition curve length, some due to the always better to go with a transition length. Transition curve provides introduce the centrifugal acceleration gradually. If you have any restrictions in the length of transition curve, then there you have to require to reduce the safe speed or permissible speed. And we have to always try to put this resultant force center of the track, considering the resultant of the centrifugal force and weight of the vehicle. Now we have Martin's formula to calculate the safe speed for broad gauge and meter gauge. You can see here, for transition curve is V equal to 4.4 square root of R minus 70, and V is in kmph, R is in radius in meter. For non-transition curves, we have 4/5 of the speed calculated using equation 1. For non-transition, we take the 4/5 of this value, that will be your safe speed. For narrow gauge, we have V equal to 3.65 square root of R minus 6. And again, it is subjected up to 50 kmph. Again, for non-transition curves, we have V equal to 2.92 square root of R minus 6, and again subject to 40 kmph. But Indian Railways are not using, no longer using these equations. So what are those equations they have modified? Let us see in this. So these are the equations. Considering they have defined the permissible speed, considering the cant access, cant deficiency and actual cant provided. So here on broad gauge, we are using this railway board formula, that is simplifying 0.27 square root of CA plus CD multiplied by R. Again, here is CA is the actual cant or equilibrium cant, and CD is your cant deficiency, and R is in radius in meter. And on meter gauge, you have 0.347 square root of CA plus CD into R. On narrow gauge, we have 3.65 square root of R minus 6, again subject to maximum of 50 kmph. This is for the previous slide which we have discussed. It is for the transition curves. Whenever you have no restrictions of transition curves, there is no side constraint of transition curve, in that condition, the formula holds good to calculate the safe speed. So when we have non-transition curves, So we have a non-transition curve with Kant. This is how we are providing the virtual transition, that is 14.6 meter on broad gauge and 13.7 meter on meter gauge and 10.3 meter on narrow gauges. For non-transition curve with Kant, we are providing the super safe speed. To calculate your safe speed, considering the Kant gradient not to exceed 1 in 360 on broad gauge and 1 in 720 on meter gauge and narrow gauge. So non-transition curve with no Kant, we have permissible Kant efficiency to be gained or lost, or use rate of change of Kant efficiency as 35 mm per second for broad gauge and 55 mm per second for meter gauge. So curve with inadequate transition, we are providing the actual Kant or Kant efficiency with considering to its limiting value, or considering rate of change of Kant efficiency within their limits. So now how do you calculate the maximum permissible speed on curves? We are taking the least of these, comparing the calculating the four speeds by this method and taking the least of the speed limits mentioned over here. So first we have to take care the maximum sanction speed of the train that is authorized by the Commission of Railway Safety. First this is the first speed we have to take it, and the second speed is considering the Kant efficiency and considering the actual Kant, we are calculating the what is the safe speed. So this is the second safe speed we are calculating, considering the Kant actual Kant and Kant efficiency. And third one, it is based on the low speed vehicle, that is considering the goods train, they are traveling with the lesser speed. So for that also we are calculating the speed. And fourth criteria, considering the transition curves corresponding to the length of the transition curves. Calculate the speed for all these four method and take the least of the value as the safe speed. And also we have to consider the maximum Kant efficiency is 100 mm and Kant excess is 75 mm on broad gauge and 65 mm on meter gauge while calculating your safe speed. So these are the references I have used for preparing this presentation. Thank you.